This is Rob Flynn from Machine Head, and you're watching Loudwire.
There are actually a lot of stylistic changes on this record, a lot of sort of interludes. One that I wanted to talk about was sort of a folky protest anthem called Bastards. That one really stuck out to me. Is that song based on real conversations that you've recently had with your kids?
Yes.
It is.
Yeah, it was based on a conversation I had with my kids the day after the election. And it was a really difficult conversation and a complicated conversation. And I just sat down the next day and I wrote those words down and picked up an acoustic guitar and I started strumming four chords that I've heard a million times over the last 100 years, but it just worked. And, you know, I put it up on YouTube a few days later, just as an acoustic version of it, and just me singing it. And at that point, I thought it was just kind of done with. I thought it was like, okay, we're, you know, that's it. And then somewhere along the line, we recorded as a band, and it turned into this full band version, and we just rolled with it. It's kind of out of our wheelhouse having a song like that, but it's a f-ing good song, man. And so we just went with it.
Obviously, the day after the election was a difficult one for a lot of people. I can't imagine having kids that day. Is that a difficult conversation to have, to essentially with the narrative of the song saying sometimes the bad guys win?
That's just words that were spoken during the conversation, and then somewhere when I was writing it, it kind of turned into just my own thoughts on it. I mean, I wrote that song in 30-40 minutes, and just it was done, and it pretty much was just all in order. You know, sometimes that's how music happens. You know, sometimes it's just this burst of whatever. I think music is oftentimes just a snapshot of where somebody's head is at the moment. And that moment may not be the same 10 years from now, or it might be the same 10 years from now, but that's where my head was at, and we just rolled with it, man.
Yeah. Well, this album kicks off with a real punch to the mouth with Volatile. Starts off with Big F*** the World. Lyrics like, sick of the racists, sick of the NRA trying to scare me. It really is sort of a snapshot of 2017. I'm kind of trying to figure out at what point in the year did you write it, because it really could have been written at any time this year, frankly.
The lyrics were written on the same day as Charlottesville. And, you know, I've been watching that happen. We're in the studio. I've been watching all that happen, and over the 2 days or whatever it was going on. And I remember we watched that video of Heather Mayer getting run over and killed, and I was just like, the f*** is going on, man? And I just went into the lounge of the studio, and I just wrote lyrics for about 20 minutes, and 20 minutes later, I was singing it, and you pretty much hear my first and second take of recording the, you know, there was no lyrics up until that point, and like I said, that snapshot of somebody's headspace, just, you just got a snapshot of me pissed off and raw anger and frustration and confusion and, you know, white supremacist marching every 2 weeks in the U.S. now, and it's pretty fucking insane.
For sure. I remember reading your general's journal on Charlottesville after it happened. I remember you mentioning that your wife didn't want you to write about that because of issues you've had in the past addressing racism and metal, death threats that you've received and stuff like that. Was it at all difficult to make the decision to choose to address racism in a song with that past?
I think anytime anybody does it, it's rough. And, you know, a lot of people, you know, I've been on press tour for 3 weeks now.
Yeah.
Man, every day I get people going, you know, you're the dude who stands up and says shit. And I'm like, I don't want to be the dude who stands up and says shit. Like, that ain't, you know, that's not the title I want. Give that to somebody else. I mean, for me, I just, every once in a while, you know, there's tons of shit that I don't say anything about. You know, tons of shit.
Sure.
And I think about it all the time. And especially after, you know, in light of everything that went on a year and a half ago, I think I don't even think twice. I'm thinking like 10 times before I put anything up. And every once in a while, I just say something. You know, I mean, I just, you know, man, I'm 50 years old. I'm on album number 9. I'm going to be dead pretty soon here.
Come on.
And you know what? I am. It's true. And like, I'm just going to live my life, and I'm going to do it. And most of the shit that I say and most of the songs that I write are going to be forgotten. And I'm just going to live my life and do what I think is right. And I can't really see it any other way. And I'm an artist, and I think being an artist means expressing yourself in a pure form and not watering it down. And you know, you understand that by doing whatever, a general journal or a song, like you're putting your art out to the world, and the world is there to judge it. That's the point of it. And people are gonna love it and people are gonna hate it, but you know, you just gotta be yourself. You gotta really just own it and be yourself.